If the words sampujayet karma here mean that one should worship the laws of karma governing our activities, then one may astutely ask what it means to worship laws, and indeed, what might be the origin of such laws, and who is maintaining them. To say that laws have created or are maintaining the world is a meaningless proposition, since there is nothing about the nature of a law that indicates it could generate the existential situation it is supposed to govern. In fact, worship is meant for Krishna himself, and this real conclusion will be clearly revealed in this chapter.
要是能称它为地宫，主Krishna在此提出现代时髦的汪洋哲学，即我们的工作或者职业是真正的神，所以我们应该只是崇拜我们的工作，仔细观察，我们发现我们的工作只不过是务实虚拟，以务实思想相互作用，正如主Krishna本人以更认真的态度在《薄伽梵歌》第三章的第28个中师节中说明。 感官以感官对象的相互作用，古纳古古内苏瓦塔达，相信这相信人为的无神论哲学，功利性活动论承认今生的善良活动使我们的来生有更好的处境。如果这是真的，那么就必然存在着有别于躯体 的有意识的灵魂，如果这也是事实，那么超然的灵魂为什么要崇拜短暂、躯体与务实思想的相互作用？如果这师节中文中的梵文，人应该潜心崇拜他的规定活动，三不加耶伽玛，一句的意思是人应该崇拜掌管我们活动的业报定律。那么人也许 可以敏锐地问询问，崇拜法力是什么意思？什么可能是这种法力的源头？谁维护他们？说法力创造或者维系着整个世界是毫无意义的说法，因为法力本的本质并没有表明它能产生它该管制的存在属境。事实上，唯一崇拜的对象是 Krishna 本人。
而这一章将明确地揭示了这一真正的结果。 Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhakta Vanda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare.
Lord Krishna is speaking. Is it Chitra Balasi? Guangdonghua?
Guangdonghua.
Chitra Balasi. Lord Krishna is speaking the philosophy of Karma Mamamsa to discourage his father from performing the Indra Yagya. Karma Mimamsa is one of the six philosophical systems which are prominent. There are six main philosophies in the world, and Karma Mimamsa is one of them. Karma Mimamsa philosophy comes from a great sage called Jainini. the other philosophical systems. You have, for example, you have Gautama taught logic. Taught logic. Lord Kapila taught Sankhya. And Patanjali taught the yoga. Patanjali taught yoga. Astavakra taught the atomic theory. Astavakra. Atomic theory. And Vyasadeva taught the Vedanta philosophy. So these are the six darshans, the six main philosophies. And so this Karma Mimamsa philosophy, this is the first one. This is one more of action, of karma. The others are more gyan. But Vyasadeva's bhakti. So Vyasadeva presents the highest philosophy. So we're hearing Lord Krishna argue today. He's presenting arguments to Nanda Maharaj, telling him why you don't have to worship Indra. Of course, Indra is a devotee, but not a pure devotee. He's got material desire. And he become a bit proud also. So Krishna did not just simply say to Nanda Maharaj that, oh, you can't worship the demigods. Of course, in the Bhagavad Gita, worship of demigods is condemned. That those who worship demigods are considered less intelligent because they get results which are limited and temporary. And the results of worship of the demigod have to be approved by Krishna before they can give. But Lord Krishna didn't just simply say all of this to Nanda Maharaj, rather he gave an alternative philosophy to Nanda Maharaj. And this philosophy is the idea that work is worship. Yeah, we often hear this said, you know, people say, work is worship, you should work, this is the real God. Work, I said work is worship. Translation is very important. This is an atheistic statement. Lord Krishna is the Supreme Lord, and he's preaching like this to Nanda Maharaj. So we have to understand, we have to
we shouldn't base too much on this philosophy. Don't give too much importance to this philosophy. Lord Krishna is simply using it to change the mind of Nanda Maharaj. But it is not actually the proper philosophy. But Krishna is telling Nanda Maharaj that work is the God. God. So Prabhupada, in the purport, we're given some nice arguments about this. First of all, Prabhupada explains, he said that the Karma Mimamsa philosophy, the idea is that you get a better life in the future. If you do good work in this life, then you'll get a better life in the next life. So this indicates that there's something higher than just the body. Because the body is not going to be elevated in the next life. What's going to be elevated is the soul. So we understand there's another principle beside, there's something else beside the body that is the soul, the spiritual part. So we should understand that spirit soul, that is actually the thing which should be worshipped, which should be understood. So Prabhupada said, well, if we are souls, if there is a the spirit soul, why should you worship material body? You don't worship the dress, you worship the person in the dress. The dress of the king, you know. You don't worship just the dress of the king. Of course, sometimes people are so stupid, they do these things. They had that lady, she was the Prime Minister of England, Mrs. Thatcher. Did you hear her name? Mrs. Thatcher. She was the Prime Minister of England for a long time. She was very careful how she dressed. She would always, you know, perfect shoes, and bag, and hat, and everything. And so they collected all her clothes. They made an exhibition all of her clothes. Movie stars, you know, they're always very careful how they dress, what they will wear. But it's not the clothes which make the person, but it's the person himself. That person comes from the soul. So it's foolish to worship the body. The body is this interaction of the material energy. So then the second argument is Prabhupada takes this word from the purport, this word which says Sampujayat karma. One should fully worship karma, his work. You should worship his work. But Prabhupada explained this karma activity indicates some law of material nature. Karma, yeah, there's some laws there, the laws of karma. We talk about the law of karma. Right. If you do good, you get good. You do bad, shan yo shan bao, er yo er bao. Jong do de do, jong gua de gua. This is. This is laws of karma. So the law, we don't worship the law, we worship the law maker. Yeah, it's the person who made the laws which is important. There are so many laws, we don't worship the law, we follow the law. And so the laws are showing us, teaching us something, but what's important, you know, that they're made by a person, there's a person behind them. So this is what's important, and this should be understood in this relation to this philosophy. Yeah, we can't. There's laws, they don't just come about but by themselves. There's somebody has to implement them. So, worship is meant, you know, we're meant to not worship the law, as the law maker is Krishna, we should worship Krishna.
And
of course, this is the whole purpose of this pastime here in worshipping Govardhan Hill, that Krishna himself is Govardhan Hill. So Krishna is very expertly changing the worship from the worship of Indra to the worship of Govardhan Hill, and Krishna will assume the form of Govardhan Hill. Because it's Krishna who should be worshipped. Not just simply the work. So there's so many atheistic philosophies. This is also an atheistic philosophy. But the interesting thing is this atheistic philosophy is coming from God himself. So time, everything depends on the particular time and circumstances and situation. Lord Krishna is using this for a particular purpose. That he wants all the people of Vrindavan to take up the work. Pure devotional service. He doesn't want them to be worshipping demigods. You can see Prabhupada also, how Prabhupada, he didn't want us to also worship the demigods either. Prabhupada, he didn't encourage us to worship. Because we'll get diverted, we'll forget the goal. And we'll end up thinking it's all the same, they're all one. We think there's no difference, Krishna, Shiva, Indra, Brahma. But it's actually Krishna who is the Supreme Lord, and we worship Him. At the same time, we're respectful, we offer our respects to the other gods.
And
we don't disrespect them. Of course, Indra took offense against Krishna. He took offense. He said, this Krishna, he's a talkative child. He thinks he knows everything. He doesn't know anything. He's a foolish. So of course, Indra got really angry and he sent his clouds there to Vrindavan to destroy everyone. You can see how pride can influence the heart of a person. That although Indra had good karma, he must have had a lot of pious activities to become the king of heaven, but still he became so proud that he wanted to kill all the cows and all the people in Vrindavan. So pride is such a dangerous thing. And that pride, that identification with the material body, Indra was thinking, they don't want to do my puja. They're supposed to worship me. Got so angry too. Such a drastic step to send the clouds, which are meant to annihilate the universe at the time of devastation at the end of the world, sent them to. So Krishna was arranging all of this so that he could be more worshipped. Because after seeing Krishna pick up Govardhan Hill, then everyone was thinking how wonderful Krishna is. Because Krishna is so wonderful, that's why we want to worship him. We don't want to worship our work. There's nothing worshipable in our work. No, we have to work. We have to do our work. But we don't worship it. Worship is given to the Supreme Lord. So, this is the teaching. Lord Krishna teaches this himself, of course, Bhagavad Gita. That whatever we do, whatever we offer, do it as an offering for Him. So, we have to understand these different atheistic philosophies. Okay, any questions? Any comments? Big one?
So it's better for them to worship demigod or they worship work. Different level. It sometimes takes time for people to worship directly to God. What we should suggest? Oh,
Though the Vedas prescribe worship of the demigods, and then the worship of demigods will lead to worship of the Supreme Lord. There's no provision for worship of work. Worship work. People like mudhas, right? Mudhas, they never surrender to Krishna. People like donkeys, foolish animals like a donkey. They just want to work. I have to work. I have to do my work. Prabhupada says like a donkey. They have to carry rocks to eat grass. But grass is growing everywhere. So you don't see the donkeys becoming devotees. You don't see people becoming devotees just by working. How would you worship work? You're going to offer arti to your work? You're going to worship, have to worship your work. You're going to offer prayers to your work. No, but offering prayers, offer worship, we can do that to demigods. And then we understand that the results of that worship is limited and temporary. And then, therefore, we should think how to get something which is eternal. I want eternal benefit. So the Vedic path is like that. You begin, you worship the demigods, and gradually you come up and you come up to worship the Supreme Lord. But we don't have time to do all that. If we know that worship of the Supreme Lord is ultimately the goal, immediately go there.
People worship work.
Because they got money. If no pay, they will not work. So they worship money. How do they worship it? They value it. They want it. They desire it. But how do they actually worship it? Yeah, they may get the money and they put it on their altar and offer arti to it.
Put in a frame.
Put it in a frame.
Yeah,
we bow down to it, right? Offer our obeisance. People may want something very badly, they desire something a lot, they want to get money, they want to get these kind of things, but they don't.
Just need to worship.
How to worship, that is only understood when we see that how to worship the deity. How do you worship something? You offer respects to it. You see, we worship money to get money so that we can have it, use it. But we don't really worship it. Worship means you accept, you put yourself in the mood of being the servant of someone. But we're thinking the money is for me to use. We don't become the servant of the money.
We're
thinking the money is for my service. Money is for my service. It's for me. We think it's mine. We don't think I am his. We should think of ourselves as being the servant, or we're the property of Krishna. We can come before the deity and say, I am yours. You're my Lord, you're my Master. But we don't have that same mood when we're dealing with money. We're attached, we want the money. But we want it for our service. We don't want.
You can use money to serve Krishna.
Yes, that's a very nice way.
We can
use everything for Krishna. Not only money, use everything for
Krishna.
It's all Krishna's, it belongs to Him. We have to use it for His service. So He gives us that opportunity. Yes?
There is money, goddesses, Lakshmi.
Huh?
That's why money is for Lakshmi.
Money, Devi God.
Yeah, people worship Lakshmi. But Lakshmi is the wife of Lord Narayan, right? Lakshmi is also Chanchala. She's Chancho, restless. She does not stay in one place. Would you like a girlfriend or a wife like that, who is restless? No, you should stay with me, right? You don't go.
Don't.
If she's Chancho, yeah. You'll always be in anxiety. Where is she? Where's she gone? What's she doing? So if we want Lakshmi, we have to have Narayan. First you have to get Narayan, then Lakshmi. She's a very chaste wife, actually. She never leaves Lord Narayan. She's always with Lord Narayan, but in our hands she's restless. Lakshmi, in our hands, we cannot keep her.
Right?
You get the money, it soon goes.
Right?
You give it to Krishna Leela, she'll soon spend it. Have a wife, she'll take all the money and spend it. Where's all the money? So we cannot keep Lakshmi in our hands. So we have to give it to Krishna, quick. Quickly use it for Krishna. But if you keep Lord Narayan with you, then Lakshmi will always
come.
Prabhupada said, just like Birlas, he said they will always build temples of Lord Narayan, Lakshmi Narayan. So their business is always good. Always have a lot, one Indian family, Birla.
Big industry,
big rich family. They're very famous in India.
What about that then?
They said,
Prabhupada
said, they're famous in India.
Yeah, they
said, because they build temples for Lord Narayan, they're always rich, they're blessed by that.
They're famous,
they're
famous. They're
famous, they're
famous.
They're famous, they're famous.
So you worship Lord Narayan, Lakshmi will also
come.
Okay, Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai. Shri Prabhupada ki jai.